This is Dr. Bill White again, and this is a continuation of Class 3 non-surgical correction. This particular case here is a very slight Class 3, along with excessive fullness and a crossbite in the midline problem. The Class 3 crossbite and midline were corrected early on. The remaining anchorage was used to reduce the fullness of the face. We again took out the lower 6-year molars in doing this case. I'm going to switch it now to we'll have a large screen so we can see it better here, and I'm going to collect my little pen to do this again. This young lady is a very brilliant young lady, and she's slightly full and has a several problems that we mentioned earlier there, and you can see the fullness of the face that we want to reduce this some from this angle also. So we've got a little cross bite over on this side, and it's coming out over here with a lot of midline problem you can see there, and just a kind of a, not a bad Class 3 problem at all. So we can use this technique of removing the lower 6-year molars to do other than, you know, rather severe Class 3. Now you want to make sure you've got second molars and wisdom teeth in there when you go in to do this type of surgery. So again, here we're going to take out the 6-year molars on the bottom. You can see right here, we'll remove these teeth, and we're going to bring these teeth forward and these back till we correct the Class 2, and the remaining of this we'll use, pulling this forward, we'll use to bring the anterior teeth back to reduce the profile to some extent with it. And you can watch what takes place in this case. Here is our x-ray. This young lady is 15 years and 3 months old right now, and this was in 03, and we had good wisdom teeth. They're impacted, and you'd have to certainly lose them if you didn't approach it this angle. They're good 6-year molars, and you hate to take them out, but you can correct the problems with doing this, and you almost dead sure to be able to put the wisdom teeth in this place. So we're going to take out the 6-year molars and just remove them. We'll bring this back now on the lower anterior to a pretty good position. We'll bring it back under quite a bit, and then before we actually get these teeth up to where we want them, get the second molars now up here, and the remaining part of this, once we get this as far as we want it, we'll hook on with Class 2 elastics, and we'll pull the anterior teeth back here by finishing correcting that. Now, this sounds crazy to a lot of people, I'm sure, but it works. So this is the first panorectomy we took, and here is the next one. We've got it all lined up and ready to go. Everything is there, and we like to take the teeth out and then start the movement even that very same day. The day we get the teeth out. Now, here we'll we've removed the teeth and we're starting to bring this forward. I'm sorry the picture doesn't take in the second molar here completely. So maybe it'll show up in another Panorex. This is our third Panorex that we'll be taking. And we're bringing this tooth forward. And you notice how far it's moved away from this wisdom tooth right here. And we're bringing it bodily. So right here at this area where we're bringing it out, we've got this little loop in that wire coming off like that, and this tail end of it's activated that way. And we tie into this, you see, to pull it forward. And we tie the archway back real tight. We've got this same kind of little loop over on the other side with it going down like that. Now, you see the roots are coming forward at the same time the crown is, and the tooth is staying just straight up and down. You can look at the periodontal membrane over here and see how it is. You can see a little space in between there, but if you hold it, it'll fill back in, and this tooth will hit and just kind of taper right on up into place right in here. Okay, let's continue. We'll bring up another Panorex here. Now we've got the roots going ahead of the crown, a little bit too much activation, so we pull on a little harder, you see, and that'll bring the lower anterior back further maybe than we want, but we're going to correct this fullness of the face by bringing the upper maxilla back by pulling the rest of the way forward. So here's what's going on. Now we're almost together and we've got the roots parallel. And this is a beautiful example of dragging the teeth forward and carrying the roots with you as you go. These roots have come forward the same amount as the crown. And as we moved away from these wisdom teeth, they began to kind of come up like that, you see. So they're headed in. It's a real nice example of that. And we're almost together over on this side. And our midline seems to be corrected quite good. Marked it up there so you can see it now better. Now this second molar up above, you really need to band that and get a good arch work, or just drop down a little bit more than the other teeth. This one, it came in and rested on the back of this tooth right here, so it's not as big a problem. Now over on the left side, we have it further forward, and so this tooth is dropped down a little further than you want it. On the right, this tooth is in good shape, so we will bring this on up and have it occlude right in there, you see. Now, the next one, we've closed this completely, and see, we've got this one hanging down. It's going to drop down further. We've got to get that, so you need to get your arch wire going through your six-year molar and the second molar, and as heavy arch wire as you can to hold that tooth up in position. We're at 2005, right up there now. So let's see what our final Panorex will be. She's age 17 now, and 5, and so this one is just a blown-up picture of that other. She's still 17. I just moved it over to shoot this side right here. That's virtually the same Panorex. Let me go back and erase that. Let me put in there. All right. We've got her in an upper retainer at this time. We've taken head off, and we're holding this back up on this side, and we're pretty well finished with this, so we're going to have to retain and maintain this tooth in position up here and pull it forward and get something holding it up where it won't drop down. So we make a retainer when we're doing this that actually has acrylic that comes under the edge of this tooth but doesn't keep this tooth from erupting into it while we wait for this wisdom tooth to come on into the mouth. And when you do this on young people, you have to hold this up right here. So you do it with a retainer, which I'll show you later on how we keep this retainer from dropping down, and you clue against this, and that won't let this tooth come any further down. And while we wait for this one to come up and come in contact with it. Now here it's leveled out pretty good, and this is a little later, and I don't have the date. I don't see the date on that picture right there. So we've taken it off of the top and had her in retainer for some time while we finish waiting on the bottom to erupt. And you notice how these wisdom teeth just came right on up in place, right like that. And that we'll clue on that, bring this one in, and this will just level out like that. So now we've taken it off, and this is 07, so this is several years have passed. This is leveled out real good. We've still got a three, we have a 3-3, which will remain on the case. In fact, that just shows a 2-2, I believe, on one side. It's broken, it hasn't contacted over here. Okay, this is kind of blown up, showing the two sides again and how the teeth are coming in contact. All right, we'll go through it a little better clinically, which I can show you the problem that we had, a midline problem. So we've got a hooks here for correcting across that way. And we're in a good class one relation back here. We're finishing pulling this up with this elastic chain. This is 2004, so we're sliding this forward, and the crowns and the roots are going forward at about the same pace. So we'll close all this up. We're using elastic chain, you see, to bring them forward here. Come under this, and it's pulling this forward. It's also pulling this back to some extent, which is pitting three teeth against two up here. And the final part of this will come off with class two elastics up here to fix that up. Okay, here's 2005. The teeth are lined up real good, and we're using some class two elastics on this side, so you see when we came off right in here. The class two elastics. Okay. Now at this point we're just about to finish the case up. The upper's lined up real good, and the lower, we've got it closed up. We're waiting on this wisdom tooth to come in, and this one is pretty well in over on this side. So we'll have to hold up there a little till we get those in place. Now here's the young lady down the way. We've got some reduction in the fullness of the face, but not all that much. And you can get the idea of some of the reduction. I'll have to compare these faces in just a minute, and we can see how they look. Here's the smile line. She's showing a little extra gum tissue there. So here's the models. This is 7 of 03, that before we actually started the case. That's again from the left side, and you see we're planning to extract those teeth. And the midline's off that far. The upper had problems, and we went in and kind of straightened all this out and gave it a pretty good form here. We'll have to kind of show this, compare it with the finished product here. And the bottom looking like that. On the inside you can see the crossbite problem that we had. And here was the fullness in the 7 of 03, and we started nearly 8 of 03. All right, here's the finished upper, more or less. And we've got the bottom still in treatment. It's pretty well lined up. That's a pretty darn good class one relationship right there. Let me go see. And the midline is corrected. And the other side is slightly, could be a little bit better if we had this back a little further. It's not perfect. Now on the bottom we have closed up. This wisdom tooth has come in. That one is still in process, so we have to hold that tooth up until that does come in. And we have finished a lot of them, just completely come out of the bottom and just put a bond in 3 to 3 in here. And we have the upper retainer that will allow this tooth to erupt down into this space. And you have to do that on younger children and where their wisdom teeth haven't come in. So here we build a retainer. There's no that we put on the bottom. This is the upper retainer. We covered these teeth over so they can't erupt down any further. Now we have to look at that from the side. Now here she is after we've finished her up, and you see a much more desirable profile than she had to start with. There was her starting profile, and just look at that again. She's got her head kind of cocked up there, and it kind of detracts from it. But let's see. You can see the fullness. Much, much improved profile deal. Now from the front, the lip, the gum exposure seems to not be there, at least in this pose she's got here. I don't see any gum line problem there. Now you can see the definite fullness in this face with the class 3 protruding out right like here. It just looks a heck of a lot better if you take that down. So So anyway, I don't have the final pictures here for you. We kept that retainer on to the lower wisdom teeth, got up in underneath there, and it held the upper molars in position there until the other teeth came in. Now here's a case number three. This is a extremely severe class three case. And we use it to ensure that we use blocks in doing this type of thing. We just have to get to this fella. He's got his head cocked up, I'm sorry. But if we look at the facial structure, it looks pretty normal, you know. And you can see the maxilla looks like it's a little bit small in here. But it's not that bad appearance from the outside. But then when we look at his teeth, his upper teeth actually fall completely behind the lower teeth, until which they ground the enamel down on the lapel of the upper teeth, and it'd be on the lingual of the lower teeth. And when he closes his teeth together, these teeth come in contact back here, and these will go way down here somewhere. And these lower teeth will come up to the top. It's really looks pretty hideous. You see him come down like that, and it almost covers his upper front teeth up in there. Now here we did not take any of the teeth out that he's got. But he had lost a lot of upper teeth in doing this. So this case is rather extreme, and it looks extremely difficult to do. You know, and I'm sure if he had gone to a lot of other places, they would have done surgery on his jaw, no question about it. But what we do here now, we're going to come in and put some acrylic on these upper front teeth that sticks out, and then he bites down on that, and it keeps his mouth apart. Actually, if you put these teeth, these lower anteriors, up to where they were, you've got a space in here almost a half of an inch. It's not quite that much, but it doesn't like too much. And these teeth are going to move together over here until they're in contact while we're wearing this bite plate out here of this bonding material. And while this is taking place, we go in and expand this upper arch completely where it fits over the lower arch. It'll come out, these teeth will be over the lower arch when we get through with it. It's kind of interesting to watch this. It's 1988. Now the lower had some spaces in there, so we come in and kind of correct this, which is pretty simple to do. No big problem there. And so we're lining that up, and we put this acrylic on these upper front teeth. And this is a few months after treatment. And we've got an intruding arch on here. This arch would be way up here, and it's picking these front teeth up, you see, at the same time. And we've probably got reverse curve in this one. It might be something like that, which tends to put a little force on them coming down in that respect. Now, I have pushed our F9 pause this thing, and I'm going to check it later on. I'm going to go ahead now and finish this case up if we can. So we'll push F9 again and start continuing the case. So we've got an expanding arch wire in here. We got spring on it. We got this intruding wire picking that up, and we come in also with our big daddy arch, you see, and expand this out also. I haven't seen a picture of it come up here yet. So we're expanding this, and these teeth has to chew on these front teeth out here. And while he's doing that, these teeth are coming together. And remember, these lower anterior teeth went up along here, and it'd be that much space back here in the back. They're pretty close. It's a kind of a triangle, an angle going back. But these teeth are erupting into the mouth now, coming into contact. And the clinical crowns of the teeth stay virtually the same. The teeth are not moving out of the bone structure. They're moving down, and the alveolar bone is going along with these teeth as they erupt into the mouth. The bone structures following the teeth down. And so that was one thing I wanted to bring out on this case. Now we've still got to rotate these cuspids down on the bottom. And so we're doing a little bit of that rotation right now. And we've got the teeth in pretty good position. As soon as we get them in contact, we can come and take off this acrylic here on the front. So everything's looking a lot better. We've got a lot of rotation to do. We haven't finish that by a long shot. You can hook the chain elastic, and I see we've built up a little composite on this cuspid tooth right here. We're running this chain elastic. No, I'm showing the wrong way, really. We hook it over on this side. We half hitch it, bring it around under that, and then come in over here and hook it on the bracket, but not going over the arch wire, and that'll turn this tooth around. I don't know whether we did that when we show this on how to rotate these difficult cases like that. Now here we've got to bring this lateral out, you see, and this has got to come in, and this would need to come out on that side. I don't know how good we did that this case, but that's something that needs to be done on that lower arch. So here we remove the little acrylic bite block, and he bites down and chews back here, but these are not even in contact now. And you remember these lower anterior teeth were coming right along up here somewhere. So it's open tremendously. And while we were opening it, we were widening it out, and we've got the upper teeth widened out over the lower teeth now. So we're way down the line on correcting this guy. Now, somebody you've opened that much, they're going to tend to close. I mean, the day you pull this thing off, I mean, it'll start to close up like mad, and so you really have to get you an upper retainer with a bite plate or something in it real fast. And that's what we did in just a few days. Now, we've got these teeth rotated to some extent, but not near what I would like to have them, these cuspid teeth on the bottom here. So here is this large arch wire we call a Big Daddy. It could be an 040 wire, 40,000 or 36,000, one or the other. But usually, on something like this, we put about a 040 wire in there, which is pretty doggone large, and it would be expanded way out, you know, a half inch or more on each side. And you put it in there, and it starts pushing each side out, and we get these teeth in contact. Now this is closing down real fast. That's about as closed as I want to get it. So we're going to have to put something to stop the bite from closing up, even though we're still moving the thing. Okay. Now, we come back. We're still working on the bottom, but we haven't rotated those teeth properly at all. I don't know that I ever did. Now, we're closed, and so I have to come back and put a upper kind of a flipper little partial in there, and then we put a bite plate on it. So these lower anterior teeth now are coming up against an acrylic bite plate that's put on the lingual side right up against the upper anterior teeth, and now that'll hold it in place so it won't deepen anymore. And so our overjet and overbite and everything is in pretty good shape here. Now these teeth will work their way into each other over a period of time, and he's got spaces in there, so he'll have to get some bridge work done. So we come along like that. Now this is 91. Alright, I've done some of this rotation over here. You see we put a, we didn't do it like I was talking about. We put a wedge in this side, and it's corrected part of it right here. It's better to use that, you know, where you run that elastic chain around. Well, you hook it over here and run it, and come in on this side and pull that around. It's a little better way to do that. But that wedge works pretty well anyway. So here is 93, and we finished the upper, so we fixed him a retainer that fits on there with a bite plate in it. And the retainer, we just took those teeth that we had used before and put them on this retainer. He wears that until he gets some bridges put in. Now we pretty well got this rotated, but not properly. That's still not what I would like right here. This is a little better, but still not fully done. We should have gone in here and put the chain and rotated those teeth a lot better. That we can beat that. It's there now. But this is a class 3 correction that we didn't do any surgery on. They went and had some bridge work done on this, and so we had to redo the retainer and fix it up for the meat. And this large tooth back here at the back was so big I didn't re-crown it or recommend that, so we just made this tooth kind of inside. We let it occlude like that rather than build it way out over that crown. And the crown should have been taken off and redone. Now the bridge work is kind of a retainer in itself, holding it in. This guy bit so hard until he actually, in biting something, just bent this 3-3 head like that. From here he just bent it down. So I caught hold of this wire and just pulled it up in position, and the bonds held on it. That's, so we rarely ever use this to bond it like that anymore. So we bond to each tooth usually, which makes it a little more difficult in cleaning. But you can see how wide this tooth is back here, way out past it. And so our upper teeth got a clue on this side and a slight crossbite in there. And we watched him for, we see this guy all the time, even now. And I never did correct this properly there. I should have, there's a lot of things with this case I could have done even better. And you've got problems with root canals, and, but it's stable. And this is 92 here. You can see that you left that tooth occluding inside that. Got some of that on the other side too. Alright, there's 99. So still holding good. And we've seen this guy, you know, in 2010, things like that. I don't think I have any pictures of him that far out. We got a gap in here, which is okay. I could have done a lot of things a little better when I look back. He had no TMJ problem at all, even though he had this bite held back like that, because he was biting forward with it, and his condyles and fossa seemed to work quite good. And here he was in 88, and you see that in 88. This is, again, I'm going to show some of these pictures twice, but let me just run through this pretty quick. And they were taking that off. And that's 91. And that was when we were getting the retainer good. Now we get down over here, maybe I'll show you this. That's the way the model for her. Here he is. And I don't have a date on that, but that's 88. When we started, that's 90. So it didn't take us long to get him up to this place. And here he is in 98. 97. And we've seen this guy recently, and he's still holding. It's a very stable case. I've not had any problem with it at all so far. All right, here's another case where we're going to take out the lower 6-year molars. And it goes on. This is one of the first we did on this. This young lady, it's not a very good picture over there, but she's got a pretty good class 3 problem. She has some impacted teeth, upper cuspids that are impacted, and that's a problem. It really is a help in class 3 cases, because you span the mouth to get these cuspids down, and that helps your class 3. So it's really not as bad a class 3 as some of those that we've shown, but this works excellent in here, where we will reduce the profile a little bit in correcting the final part of the class 3. there's several things to bring out here. Now, we used a palatal separator on her to go ahead and expand this arch quite a bit, and that helped. And so we extract these 6-year molars, and we're going to bring these teeth back a little bit, make room, and get these cuspids out in place. So here we go again. That looks kind of conglomerated in there. We've got an expanding arch wire in the upper and a flexible wire on the bottom, which we're kind of closing the space. pulling these cuspids down in position. We've got a palatal separator in where we're expanding, and we're working off the palatal separator now with the springs. That pushes this out. We'll bring these teeth into this, bring these cuspid teeth into this space, and that helps break the class 3 itself. Down the bottom, we're extracted the teeth and we're pulling these back. And as we get this back, we'll line this up and then we can pull it back even further if we were going here with some class 2 elastics. So here's the x-ray. We had trouble getting these people to get their 6-year molars out. They didn't, their dentist didn't want to do it. But he let us, he said he didn't want to have anything to do with it, so we sent her to an old surgeon in Quincy and went ahead and took these teeth out without any question. And we had done this type of the palatal stuff and opened that prior to taking the teeth out. So once we got the lower 6-year molars removed, we're going to move this up. See, it's something like that, and there's several lessons I'd like to show in this case. We're sliding forward now with the teeth, and I've gotten over I'm not bringing this bodily forward, which is wrong, which we ought to have the tail of this wire going down like that, so we bring these roots. And this one looks like it's a lot closer when you look at it than this one, but it'll take longer because we got to bring these roots in. Round trip the tips of those roots, but getting ahead with the moving that too forward to move the crown too fast for the roots. All right, we came in and we put this little loop deal in the activated like that, and we're pulling these roots out now, and we've separated this, and this is coming on up in place, and just kind of watch it as we go through here. Now we've just about got these together. We've taken the palatal separator out, and so we'll cut it off back in here. And this is looking good, but we'll have to hold these teeth up. So when you do this, you have to band these teeth and have a solid arch wire going back in here to hold that tooth in place. Because you want to finish it and put a retainer that holds it up there while you let this wisdom tooth come up and glue against that upper second molar. We're just about there as far as closing the space and getting the roots. So we have these roots looking good now, but this space is not together as much as this one is right here. So we should have put more of this down bend in the back of this wire so the roots would have come forward earlier. Should never have let the tooth lean like that because it rotates in this area and the tip of the roots go back further, and then you got to bring them further. So we call it kind of round tripping the roots. So you just catch them and put that force on and bring those roots forward with you as you bring the crown of the tooth forward. Now we've got this is finished up. This is in 1989. And this second molar looks almost like a 6-year molar. There's not too many people, too many dentists that she goes to that would recognize that's not a 6-year molar, it's a square pair molar. And we're holding these teeth up while we let these erupt. And I never did get her back to get pictures of where both wisdom teeth had gone in. But this is, she's 17 and 9 now at that point. This is a little further down the line, and I think she's 19 and 3 now. One wisdom tooth is in. The other one hasn't quite gotten there, but she'll still be wearing this retainer to hold that tooth in. Okay, here's some of the shots as we go through with how we did some of this. You see this little loop where we've got it, this wire is activated down like that, and we're tying this tooth back, pulling this back by tying it in, and that's a bad shot to show that with. Kind of go here to it. Now this is the other side, it has the same force on it. And we've made room for those impacted teeth, and we're getting them in the mouth. This is another 87 of them. See a lot to show on that slide. To get a better view of this little loop that we built here. Now that's that loop we've shown several times before. We go down this way, circle back, and then here you actually bend the tail of it down like about almost like 45 degrees. When you stick it in up here, it goes through the back. And now you tie through this loop, you bring your tie back, sorry that keeps showing up, just tie through there and then go around the molar and pull it real tight. So you're closing it with this, just your regular intruding arch wire, this is built into the rectangular wire right here. And you tie that back. And it'll pull back on this to some extent. If you get this to class 2-ish, then you come off of here with a class 2 elastic and pull this back, and that'll help pull this further forward. But you've got to keep this activated down in here to bring those roots forward at the same time. That's a pretty poor shot there. Now we're about halfway forward with the root structure on both sides, and the teeth are sitting in there correctly. Now here's a better shot showing that. So this actually, this archway would be going down like that. And so as we run our tie through here, we pull back on this. So this archway is being pulled by this tooth moving forward. So we want to come out of this tooth sitting in here. And we've got this back. This is back past where we want it right now. So we don't want to tie too much of this from here. So we want to finish the correction of this by wearing class 2 elastics to pull that. Now with this tooth, this loop right here is what brings these roots forward on this. Now, if you want to know how to move these molars forward bodily, you need to learn how to build something like this that will, you activate it sometimes even more than that. And as you pull on it, then this brings the roots forward. You have to think about that for a minute. Now we've got the upper one lined up real good, and we'll put it in a heavier wire, and we'll also go back and get the second molars on the upper, and the bottom is coming on quite well at this point. Very much, but we've got these coming forward, and you can tell this crown is not tipped this way. It's setting pretty good, so the roots have to be pretty much underneath the crown rather than tipping it forward right here. And we're well on our way. way to close all that space up. The upper arches stand. We cut our palatal separator and left those in case we needed to hook on to something on the lingual side of it. Now we've got this bar coming out from the second molar. We'll have a, it's banded, and we have an archway that goes all the way back. That second molar holds it up in position so it doesn't drop down too fast. Now the space on the bottom is just, you know, doesn't like too much closing up. This is the one we tipped one or two fast, but it's coming down. We're all kind of head over on this side. How we've got some space on both sides of that too. Now this is 1988. We're wearing class 2 elastics. Remember I told you we finished it out with the class 2 elastics, which brings both upper and lower back, holds them back in place. Pretty close to finishing that bottom up. Now, young ladies, coming along good. We've finished the upper now, so we have to. Now we've taken the stuff off the bottom, except we've left this on while we were waiting to put the bonding one on the inside. I don't do that anymore. We just keep this in brackets and everything and then bond the one on the lingual side completely before I give this chance to move. Sometimes this will come out or in at the cuspid area back there. All right, that's the upper. Let me show that upper retainer again. Show that acrylic back part that holds that tooth up. Now right here you can see we ran a rip of acrylic over this back area, and that keeps this tooth from dropping down. Won't let it come down. And you have to kind of do that on young children when you're taking out these 6-year molars. Now we have to wait. This is 89, have to wait on this wisdom teeth to come in. Or here's 91. That holds real good. Now this wisdom tooth has come in back here. This one is still dragging its feet, but we've x-rayed it and it's in good position and should come on up. I don't think I got her back in time to take a picture of that. So anyway, that finishes that particular case. Okay, I've got a lot of stuff going on here. This is a case we did a little earlier and published something on. It's a pretty raunchy class 3 case. So this guy really tried to send him to a surgeon, but he wouldn't go into, he wasn't about to go do that. So he said, you either fix it or. And he wasn't a real good cooperative patient, but we tried. And so I'm going to speed through this one pretty good. We took out the 6-year molars, but you wait till you're really ready to go when you take them out. And this is obvious, it looks pretty hideous as far as the class 3 problem. We made it look better, but it didn't get quite what I wanted. He didn't wear the stuff like would like one too. So anyway, we're going to take out the 6-year molars, and we start closing that space up. I put a little acrylic plate on these lower anterior teeth so we could jump the bite there, and we pull that back and jumped it under there while we were working on the upper arch and expand and break cross bites, whatever you want to do when you've got that bite plate in there opening it up that wide. So that's a little kinder way. Now you immediately, when you take these out, you want to start in here just as quick as you can, taking this back and bringing this forward a little bit. Now, when this, like if this second molar gets up here where you want it, then you've got to put class 3 elastics. You want to pull this back in addition to pulling against that. Or else nowadays, sometimes you come in and put a tad right here and bond it to the tooth and won't let this come forward anymore. Let us bring all this back further. That's a neat thing you might do with these tads. So here we come in and lining this up. This was 92. Now as we start closing this space up, this frequently will do kind of like that, you know. You have to have a pretty strong arch wire and have it some reverse curve in it. It won't do that. Now as you get it together, you can kind of come in and level the thing out. So here we are, we're pretty well down the line. We've got him, got his teeth back underneath there. And but I never did get this one looking like I would really like one to. So there we've extracted. Pretty well finished with him. He had the wisdom teeth, so you don't have to worry about fixing a retainer for it. Now he's back in a good class 1. The teeth in class 1 relation, quite good. And we finish up, that's 94. I'm going to hurry on through this one. You've seen enough of this to have a stomach full of it. Now we had some plastic brackets on him that had these metal inserts, and we left that where we went in and bonded back on the back. And it's a 94. So here is, I didn't get the vertical down like I wanted to. He could really benefit having a genioplasty where they come in and take a little wedge out and raise the chin height up to something like this, you see, and reduce the profile on it as it comes back in. But he would not do that at all. So this is a pretty poor set of pictures of final stuff I've got on him. But he looked quite a bit better than he did to start with it. So I'm going to stop right here with this case and push F10.